All aboard! We're heading out on the Peripheral Component Interconnect Express. Don't worry, you won't need tickets. Just a really fast design. Doesn't it seem like just yesterday that PCI was taken over by PCI Express? The early 2000s. How quaint. Yes, it's true that PCI Express is one of the most popular interface standards for connecting high-speed components today. But maybe you didn't know what kind of connector would be best for your next PCIe design. Well, you've come to the right place. Hi, I'm Amelia Dalton, host of Chalk Talk. In today's Chalk Talk, Matt Burns from Samtec joins me to discuss the ins and outs of PCI Express. We chat about why PCIe isn't just for PCs anymore, what PCI Express over fiber looks like, and why Samtec's team of signal integrity experts can help you with your next PCIe design. All right. All aboard! And before we get started, don't forget to click that link. There you can find even more information about this topic from Samtec. Hey, Matt, thank you so much for joining me.
Amelia, it's always a privilege to be with you on Chalk Talk.
All right, so we're talking about PCI Express today. But Matt, before we dig into the details, how did we get to where we are today?
I think it's safe to say that you and I have been in the tech industry for a while. So if you don't mind, maybe we can take down a trip down memory lane, at least from a PCI Express standpoint. In 1992, PCI, or the Peripheral Connector Interconnect, was introduced by the PC industry to link CPUs to peripherals within the PC. That standard went through multiple revisions before PCI Express was actually introduced in 2004. In preparing for this presentation, I was shocked to see that PCI and PCIe had been around for so long, but as a tech geek, I found that interesting nonetheless. As we move forward towards today, what most engineers and system designers are focusing in on in terms of PCI Express is the latest specification, PCIe 5.0, which was released last year. As with all PCIe specifications since 2004, each standard has doubled the speed from the previous revision. So PCI Express 5.0 currently supports 32 gigatransfers per second per lane, which provides an aggregate of 128 gigabytes per second in aggregate using a x16 configuration. The current version also maintains backward compatibility to previous versions of the specifications. We get a lot of questions from the industry, what's next? Because there are many applications that want to be bleeding edge. And currently, PCI SIG, the standards body that is responsible for PCI Express, is targeting PCI Express 6.0 specification being released next year. And the target for PCI Express 6.0 is 64 gigatransfers per second per lane. One of the other things that's really interesting, at least from Samtec's perspective, is when we talk about PCI Express, it's not just for PCs and servers and data centers applications anymore. We see a number of emerging small form factors. We see a number of low power applications, including handhelds, mobile, IoT, and especially embedded computing. And something that we're also excited to talk about during our Chalk Talk today, Amelia, is PCI Express over fiber for long reach applications.
Cool. I'm excited to talk about that as well. So, Matt, can we dig into what else Samtec offers in this space?
Sure. So when we look at PCI Express holistically, Samtec offers a variety of high-performance interconnect solutions ideally suited for PCI Express architectures. We also back that up with a global team of tech experts, online design tools, and world-class customer service. From a product standpoint, we kind of view our PCI Express solutions in two areas. One is the PCIe chem add-in card form factor solutions, which include our edge card sockets, extender cables, our PCIe over fiber solutions, as well as some test solutions, which we'll detail in our Chalk Talk today with you. We'll talk briefly about some of the PCIe capable solutions that we offer, how PCI Express, you know, we mentioned earlier, there's these new and emerging and more widespread applications that are using PCIe. What are some of the interconnect solutions that we offer that support PCI Express in those type of applications, whether that's edge card sockets, mezzanine solutions and cable assemblies or high-speed, high-density arrays. And then we'll talk a little bit at the end about our technical support. PCI Express, while it's been around for decades, there's still a lot of technical nuance that goes into making a system work, especially from a signal integrity standpoint. So we'll look at some of the things that Samtec offers to ease that process for system designers.
Excellent. So Matt, let's go through a couple of those. What about PCI edge card systems? Can we talk about those a bit further?
Of course, we love to talk about these solutions because PCI Express edge cards are really the heart of our offering. Samtec has offered edge card solutions for decades. When you look at our overall portfolio, we offer solutions from 0.5 millimeter all the way to 1 millimeter. So a variety of pitches, a variety of applications, a variety of configurations. For PCI Express solutions, these all use a 1 millimeter pitch. We have solutions at PCI Express 3.0. Not only do we offer vertical, but we also offer edge mount and right angle solutions as shown in the illustration here. For PCI Express 4.0, in addition to those configurations, we also offer a low profile solution. You can see the graphic in the lower central part of the slide here that our PCIe LP connector offers system designers an additional 3 millimeters of height on the AIC. That's not for everybody, but in some applications, those extra 3 millimeters of PCB space can mean the difference between a system working or not working. And then we also have our PCI Express-G5 or PCI Express 5.0 edge card solutions that are readily available. We've actually worked with some of our partners, PLDA being one. They've actually come up with a PCI Express development kit targeted at 5.0 performance levels using our solution. So we're real excited to see the market taking off for the latest and greatest solutions available on the market.
Cool. Now, Matt, you also mentioned cable assemblies, right? What do you guys have in this arena?
That's a great question, Amelia. In my opinion, probably our most second popular product in terms of requests for PCI Express performance are our jumper cable assemblies. We currently have solutions that support PCIe 3.0 and 4.0, and we're actively working on our PCIe 5.0 solutions. These cable assemblies can be configured as a jumper or as an extension cable. These work really well when debugging add-in cards within a development or test environment. We also see a lot of customers use these to run PCI Express signals from card to card to card to card, in a multi-PCB system. These solutions are available in custom lengths to support any type of solution. And they do support standard lane counts by 1x4, by 8, and by 16. As the illustration shows, these cable assemblies have an edge card or a connector on either end. These mate very easily with our edge card systems that we mentioned in the previous slide.
Okay, great. Now, Matt, what about PCIe over fiber? That seems really cool.
It is cool. The versatility of the jumper cables that we talked about in the previous slide, Amelia, opens up a lot of doors for PCI Express over long distances. PCIe 3.0 and 4.0 data rates, some of those cable lengths can, be maybe a meter or two or a little bit longer depending upon the overall system performance. However, there are a number of emerging applications where customers want and desire to run PCI Express signals over longer lengths. So that really forces moving from a copper domain into an optical domain. We've talked in previous Chalk Talks about our Firefly midboard interconnect system. One of the subsets of Firefly is what we call our PCUO series, or PCIe over fiber optical engine. Takes electrical signals in, PCI Express plus sidebands, turns it into an optical signal, and then it can transmit those signals up to 100 meters within a system or from box to box. Our current PCUO series supports PCIe 3.0. We have PCIe 4.0 under development. We're very close to having that available. We do have prototypes available for customers that may be interested. PCUO does support PCIe protocols for low latency, power saving, and guaranteed transmission. We do support both transparent and non-transparent bridging, so that makes system design flexible in terms of the types of solutions that engineers can design into their system. PCUO is very easy to design into downstream systems, making them smaller. And for ruggedized or industrial applications, we do also offer extended temperature versions from minus 40 to 85 and minus 5 to 85°C. Amelia, while PCUO is the ideal solution for PCIe over fiber for midboard applications, that doesn't support all applications that we see requests for. One of the other solutions that we've worked on is our PCOA series, which, as you can see in the illustration, is an adapter card with Firefly on it. This utilizes our PCUO Firefly optical cable assemblies, but it puts it in the form factor of a PCIe CAM AIC add-in card using a x16 configuration. Our current PCOA supports PCIe 3.0, but we're actively working on PCIe 4.0 as we speak. We do have prototypes of the PCIe 4.0 version of PCOA available right now, and we should have that released in the very near future. Some of the features of PCOA is it offers scalable configurations for cost-optimized performance. Even though it comes in a x16 configuration, it can be used in a x4, either in a single, dual, or quad configuration. It can use a single or dual x8, or it can use a single x16. PCOA also offers transparent or non-transparent bridging for system flexibility and multiprocessor support.
All right, Matt, can you give me an example of where PCUO and PCOA might be used?
Amelia, I want to congratulate you because saying PCUO and PCOA and PCIe so quickly is not easy, and you did a great job on that, so I appreciate
Thank you.
That. But yeah, that's a great question. You know, we have been surprised at the ingenuity and creativity of our customers and partners in some of the applications where these solutions have been able to be used. You know, in past Chalk Talks, we've talked a lot about Vita-type applications. You know, one of the most popular standards within the Vita community is the VPX form factor. It's an embedded computing architecture and form factor that's used in a lot of mil-aero, industrial, hardened, rugged applications. One of the subsets of VPX is that it has to conform to a testing standard called Vita 46. And one of the applications of that is actually putting these embedded computing platforms on a shake and vibe table and then shaking them up to a shake and vibe specification as outlined by those Vita standards. Lots of times, you have to take the embedded computing board, the module, put it on a carrier card, and then put it on a shake and vibe table that's illustrated here on this table, this white table on the left, and basically just test it until it fails. As you can imagine, embedded computing modules and embedded computing carrier cards are not cost effective. They're very expensive. So instead of doing shock and vibe both on the module and the carrier card, we've actually worked with one of our customers who has developed a test fixture that takes the module itself, attaches it to a cost-effective backplane, and routes PCI Express from the VPX module to the backplane to our PCUO. If you look at this illustration, you can see the aqua-colored fiber optic cable that mates from PCUO to the PCOA add-in card that's attached to the embedded computing computer on the fixture on the lab table. So this is a very elegant solution, and it solves a really unique problem within the embedded computing space by allowing embedded computing companies focused on rugged applications to test just the module instead of a module and a carrier card on a shake and vibe table. So we're real excited to see, you know, this one customer has adopted this solution. We're real excited to see if the rest of the industry can adopt this as well as a testing methodology for Vita 46 testing going forward.
Okay, Matt, so what does Samtec offer in terms of other solutions that support PCIe?
So far throughout the Chalk Talk, we've talked about PCIe-focused solutions that support CAMAIC or other PCI Express form factor applications. However, we're starting to see, because PCIe is propagating throughout systems, other requests to route PCIe protocol over a number of our interconnect solutions. So if you look at the graphic here, this is just a synopsis of almost everything that we offer. We see PCIe running over any number of our high-speed board-to-board connectors, our flyover technology, and our high-speed cable assemblies, backplane interconnect solutions, front panel, whether that's optical or copper, and any number of solutions in between. So the key takeaway from this slide is that if any of your listeners need to route PCIe throughout their system, Samtec not only has the interconnect solution to route those signals, but also the system level expertise to help optimize their system for the performance that's needed.
Excellent. So what about technical support, Matt?
Well, as with any design, it's not just a matter of plugging and playing a interconnect and your system gets up and running. So our signal integrity engineers are able to work with customer engineers or partner engineers to understand their system holistically and then offer our industry-leading technical expertise on high-performance interconnect systems, backed up with testing, validation, system optimization, and easy to use design and development tools to get the performance that PCIe system designers need. Our frontline engineering services can offer high data rate simulations, channel analysis, SI models, PCB and breakout region designs, as well as connector selection and those types of applications. And our technical application support and tools team can offer system level SI PIN expertise, testing, validation, and analysis, full channel optimization and design support, as well as industry leading online design tools.
Excellent. Well, Matt, I think that's about all I have time for today. But before we go, can you recap your main points for me?
Sure. One of the things that we hope your listeners take away today, Amelia, is that Samtec offers a complete portfolio of high-performance interconnect ideally suited for PCI Express architectures. This includes support for PCIe 3.0, 4.0, 5.0, and beyond next-generation solutions. We offer a number of solutions that support the PCIe ChemAIC mechanical form factor, including our edge card solutions, our PCI Express jumper cable assemblies, and our PCIe over fiber solutions. We also offer a number of PCIe capable applications, as we mentioned, from front panel and midboard to backplane. And lastly, we offer a future-proof interconnect portfolio that supports 56G PAM4 and higher speeds. We summarize all of this in a new PCI Express interconnect solutions guide, which is illustrated here on the slide. That's available for download at samtec.com/PCIe, or you can contact our technical experts at PCIe@samtec.com.
Excellent. Well, I think that is all I have time for today. Thank you so much for joining me yet again, Matt.
No problem, Amelia. It's always a fun time here talking to you and the Chalk Talk listeners.
And before we go, you didn't forget to click that link, did you? There you can find even more information about this topic from Samtec. For Chalk Talks, I'm Amelia Dalton from eejournal.com. For more Chalk Talks, head on over to the Chalk Talk section of EE Journal. You can't miss it. It's right across the top. Or head on over to YouTube, youtube.com/EEJournal.